Welcome and thanks for joining the Clark Planetarium. This is a 360 degree video, meaning that you can change your view by panning the video on your smartphone or laptop. If you were asked which object in the solar system has the most water, what would you say? Well, visibly, you can definitely see water on Earth. Out of all the planets, dwarf planets, and asteroids we know, Earth is the only one where we can see oceans and continents from space. We also get to spend time playing in puddles, floating down rivers, and swimming in lakes here on Earth. So naturally, most people would think that Earth has the most water out of any other object in the solar system. Many people might even go so far to say that Earth is the only place with water in our solar system. But it turns out that water is all over the place. And Earth doesn't even hold the title for most water in our solar system. Water comes in different forms. It can be liquid, like our lakes, solid, like icebergs, or gas, as in water vapor. You can find water in all of its forms on Earth and throughout the solar system, but let's just focus on the liquid water for now. Before we explore the solar system, let's find out just how much liquid water is here on Earth. Sometimes, since Earth is so blue, it feels and looks like it's made entirely of water. But think about the ocean floor. Underneath all that water is the Earth's crust, the same rock that we walk on every day. Cutting the Earth in half, we can see that the Earth's crust is very thin compared to the mantle and the core, and the water that lays outside of the crust is even thinner still. So all in all, if we sucked up all the water from Earth's surface and made it into its own object, it adds up to less than you think. Like I said before, you can't easily spot liquid water on other objects in our solar system. But it's there. You just have to look deeper. Take Europa, for example, an icy moon of Jupiter, slightly smaller than the Earth's moon. Despite its small size compared to Earth, it could have 2 times the amount of liquid water than all of Earth's oceans combined. But where's the ocean? Since it is so much farther from the sun than us, the surface is too cold for liquid water. But there is evidence that under the icy surface is a salty liquid ocean. The first hint of a liquid ocean came from the Voyager spacecraft all the way back in 1979, which saw strangely smooth, intersecting linear surface features that were suspected to be ice flows. Liquid water is exciting to find. Scientists take extreme interest when they find liquid water outside of Earth because that place has the potential to harbor life. There are other candidates for places with possible life in our solar system. Moving over to Saturn, we come to one of its moons, Enceladus. Enceladus is a lot like Europa, an icy crust with evidence of a liquid ocean beneath. But in this case, Enceladus sprays plumes of its liquid ocean out through cracks in its surface and into space. This provides an exciting opportunity because, in order to study the ocean, we don't have to land a spacecraft on its surface and drill 10 miles until we hit the water. Instead, Enceladus sprays free samples of its ocean out into space where a probe can pass through and study its chemistry. In fact, a probe has already done this. The Cassini probe studied material sprayed into space as it flew through one of Enceladus's plumes. Cassini found organic molecules in the ocean, meaning that there is a chance that life could exist in its waters. You may think that lakes, rivers, and streams can only be made out of water, but another moon of Saturn, Titan, has standing liquid on its surface. Titan is so cold that instead of water, it is liquid methane and ethane. While this is fascinating to study, scientists are also interested in what's below the surface. Gravity measurements by the Cassini spacecraft suggest that Titan could have a layer of very salty liquid water below its icy crust. So far, we have looked at moons, but even farther from the Earth, Uranus and Neptune may also have a form of liquid beneath their atmospheres. The atmospheres of Uranus and Neptune are mostly hydrogen, helium, and methane, but scientists have detected trace amounts of water. These giant planets increase in pressure and temperature as you descend inward. It is predicted that at some point, the combination of pressure and temperature could create a hot, dense fluid, which could be thought of as a vast water, ammonia, methane ocean within the planet. It was once thought that our solar system was a barren, waterless place, and Earth was the only oasis in this space desert. But through telescopes, probes, and rovers, evidence of water shows that we don't have to look to distant stars to search for life. Our quest to find extraterrestrial life is beginning right here in our solar system. Thanks for watching. Join the Clark Planetarium for the next part of our series, where we'll explore ice in our solar system and get a close-up view of Mars, Mercury, dwarf planets, and the comets.